I was in a pizza restaurant in Chelsea on the King's River, and suddenly I heard a song playing, and I went up to the barman, and I said, excuse me, that's a great song. Who's the singer? He said, it's those guys down the bar. So I walked up to them, and I said, well, do you have a manager? He said, no. I said, well, I'm your manager. Hi.
Remember the 80s? A time when four good-looking boys from trendy West London gate-crashed the big time. Thanks in no small part to that thing on Ben's head.
I spent the next 2 years trying to take that cap off him. You remember he had a cap that he wore back to front. And I used to say to him, no girls would ever fancy a singer who has a hat because I think you're bald.
It's just a Greek fisherman's hat. Never used to like my hair because it always looked too neat and too nice, or, like, too rubbish.
Andy Warhol, and yes, that really is Andy Warhol, directed their first video after some arch blagging by the Cats' road manager.
We gate-crashed the Warhol exhibition in some gallery in London, and I went up to the door, introduced myself, said, you know, would you as an artist like to work with four other artists? And he was like, he looked at his manager, looked at me, goes, sure.
But while now guaranteed longer than the average 15 minutes of fame, the band's lofty art house ambitions made them as out of place in the world of teen pop marketing as Mr. Wiggy was in their video.
There was always something about Curiosity that I really liked, and I would never have classed them as a standard boy band. They were just a bit edgier than all the rest of the bands that were around at the time.
People think that it was just, our audience were just sort of screaming girls, but it was actually very much a split audience.
There was a group of West London girls or whatever, posh totty, but there was also West London guys, you know, posh whatnots.
Extremely wonderful. They're bound to make the entire nation sweat. It's Curiosity killed the Cat.
The public and press sensation surrounding our feline friends was made worse as the band, and Ben in particular, started attracting the interest of fellow celebs.
Well, I met her one day when we went to do an interview for a show that she had on Channel 4. It's called Sex with Paula. I like to play around. Sweat a bit.
Sweat a bit. Certainly doing that today.
Their rock and roll lifestyle kept Ben and Co. in the headlines, and they ensured maximum tabloid outrage when they resorted to pharmaceutical aid to ease the trauma of meeting Timmy Mallett.
There's a...
Down to Earth.
Yes! Fantastic! Down to Earth. You did it in the time, so you get the whack pack, and who sings it? Curie.
There was lots of Christmas puddings from a pantomime running around, going, and we'd taken something which changed our perception slightly. Okay, yeah, we did acid.
And magic like that, he's chewing away all the way through that song, that's great.
Hey, how you doing? I'm sorry you couldn't get through. Cause this is a message that's been recorded especially for you.
Inevitably, curiosity got the better of our chums as their refueling habits took their toll.
I left the band because I wanted to stop taking drugs. I was about to become a father. And I used to see sort of guys, these guys around here doing drugs and having children around it, and I just didn't want to do that.
We were a democracy. We all wrote the songs. Everyone wrote their part. And we had this sort of pact that after someone left, we weren't going to call it Curiosity Killed the Cat anymore, or whatever. Which, hence, we call it Curiosity.
Their name had shrunk, they needed help remembering lyrics, things were going monkey. And their record company was even more confused about their latest direction than the band.
We thought we were going to release one certain single, and we turned up at the TV station and it was like some other single. I think we turned up for Jim Will Fix It or something.
Caroline here from Tolworth in Surrey, she wanted to dance like Ben from Curiosity Killed the Cat.
And what happened was that the A&R man had gone home the night before and had a bad dream about it. So decided to release a different single.
The final straw came when Ben was forced to share centre stage with Kevin, the teenager.
We still all see each other now and again. Earlier this year, we did The Lottery. We played one song, The Lottery. Funny enough, we didn't get any calls about it.